helmet. I gotta get my hater title on all my other characters. I have it on Vanu, but I don't have it on my GR. I sense probes.
Alright, I'm just setting up things.
Stab you in the crotch.
Right, already with that.
I gotta get my hater title on all my other characters. Huh.
That's,
Bonnie, but
that's by getting 60 kills on the black string. Oh, what,
I sense probes.
Oh crap. And the video. Problems.
Sorry. I could have sworn I changed the voice pack on this.
Nope.
Oh my god, this voice pack is horrible. Oh my god, Becky, like sometimes I even impress myself, and then I go to the mall and the Galleria and get a Starbucks. Ay, 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 the first time I heard the NC female voices, I'm like, is that a chipmunk?
It kind of sounds like it.
I think I'm broken, hee.
I bought the TR communist pack.
Oh, it's as manly as it gets, isn't it, on the female ones?
It's not Russian enough.
Your res is really.
You need over the
stream.
Top Russian? Oh, what? Alright,
no,
all
it's
right.
Not Russian enough.
Alright.
I hate that. The drill sergeant one's really annoying.
Yeah.
Frankly, I just don't see the real point of those voice packs. Alright, if somebody likes something, fine.
I have told my outfit mates that I'm not going to heal them if they call me a maggot.
Maggot! You goddamn maggot!
Maggot, get up off the ground!
Yeah.
What are you doing sleeping, taking a dirt nap?
Alright. Well, we are live. First off, let's chill some stuff and... yeah. If people like my stuff, you know, go and support me through Patreon and everything else. But now that the shilling is done, let's get to the point of the stuff. Well, the stream's idea is basically to give platform for you females, or women.
You?
Yeah, you. Platform where to express your opinions on, well, gaming in general, but you know, in the context as well on the plant side. So I guess Sakura, you had the general idea, so maybe you'd explain it more. Okay, alright.
Basically, like, you know, just talking about leading in game, playing in game, reactions, etc.
Alright, let's see. Well, then, let's start with the premise that you, I remember.
How about introducing the females you're talking to?
Sure,
first?
Fine, we can do the introductions. Alright, Sakura, you can introduce yourself or let me do that.
I don't really need to introduce because everybody knows my big mouth.
Well, people from other servers probably don't
My name's Sakura Gore. I'm 10 years... I mean, I'm of an age. I'm an officer in KOTV, and I'm also an officer in EDT. I'm also involved in Server Smash, I am a server rep, blah 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 blah. How you doing? Play with KOTV
right.
And shit like that.
Alright. Ninav, you're next.
I'm an officer in Mu. I'm the Miller mod at the moment. That's it.
Alright, Marilyn?
Yeah, I'm Marilyn. I play in Orbs. I'm a leader there and a recruiter, and yes. I like to play medics and engineers.
The farm.
Yeah.
Oh, the farm.
No, the support. Only the support.
Of course.
And actually, are you farming the certs?
Noble calling.
That's just noble.
We are in the presence of Miller's number one medic.
Alright, didn't know that.
Yeah, they're not yours. You didn't know that?
No, actually, I don't delve into those numbers at all. So.
You're doing a show and you don't even really, like, delve it. Oh, I'm done.
I didn't say I'm gonna be expert on the topic. I'm just saying that I'm giving you a platform where to, you know, express your thoughts. I don't think that's anything bad.
Yeah, there's a gate behind you.
It just went boom.
Okay. Alright, so the first premise I remember Sakura talking about was that females in plant side tend to play more of a support roles like medic and... Oh, generally medic, less of an engineer and so on and so forth. And
you can't really see that though.
Yeah. Well, at least in the YouTube when I watched, even on, what was it? Ah, it was in the, what was it? Pro Sieben's contest for the graphics card, I remember. There was one entry from a, goddammit, and I can't recall the name of that girl, but... She basically said that since she can't really aim that well or
that
kill
would
people.
Be me.
Really?
Oh, yes, damn, Yamik, snap!
I'm telling you, I'm terrible with names, okay, so just blame me.
Statistics, researching.
Oh, fuck you! Fuck you! But yeah, it's rather interesting. It's rather interesting that, you know, still, you see around. Well, maybe. Not as many, but. Still, quite a lot of females playing medic instead of infiltrator or light assault or well, heavy assault would be the next choice, but not as much that for that as well. Other weird, maybe some comments.
I start the game playing as a heavy, but
it's kind of how everybody started,
support.
Isn't it? Because heavy helped you kind of get into it a bit easier, because you didn't die instantaneously.
When I started, people told me that I wouldn't have to shoot anything, I could just heal things.
I've kind of stuck to light assault. I heavily enjoy light assault, and light assault and infiltrator. I enjoy sniping, I enjoy blowing some heads off on some punks, and I do play medic pretty much only on double XP or when it's requested in a fire team.
Everyone does. Everyone. Me too.
Yeah. An engineer when I'm in a vehicle, but most of the time when I'm flying, I am light assault. Because I do bail.
It's okay. I
also enjoy flying a lot.
Okay, I can't fly for shit. I only can fly galaxies.
Well, dogfighting, you're getting better, but I really do enjoy it.
I can't fly.
Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm dead.
I really can't.
Alright. Your opinion at least on... you said leading. As for females and then plant side. Yeah, if I had to pick, then probably, yeah, Merlin is one of the leads I've actually heard leading, and you, Sakura. Any comments on at least that? After all, it was your topic and idea.
What you mean, like, with leading?
Yeah, the whole thing.
It's just a question of the inevitable stupid questions. When you're talking, it's hard for females to talk in game, because either, like me, you're mistaken for a teenage boy... Because you either have a deeper voice, or they're thinking that you're a really high-pitched teenage boy.
Like, are you a girl?
It's like, gah. And I've had it to where I've actually been leading a platoon, and I've had someone call me, see you next Tuesday in platoon. And yeah, he's lucky he wasn't around, because I would have just chopped his balls off right on the spot. It's difficult to be a female lead, because people think you don't know tactics, they think you don't know anything. It's frustrating because, damn it, we know how to freaking lead. We can read a map, for God's sakes. We're not morons.
Well, yeah, I mean, Merlin, maybe you can comment on your experience as a leader and response from the people you are leading while hearing your voice and so on.
Well, I think I only get kind of nice comments, like, oh, yeah, you have a nice voice, and usually the people do what I say, at least during ops nights on Sundays, they do what I say. And for leading militia platoons, like when other outfits join or non-outfit players join the platoon, it's, well, for me, I get kind of nervous if I had to lead a whole platoon, and that's very stressful for me. Because I don't want to do like all the zerging and stuff, and I want to redeploy fast somewhere else if it's needed, if we're doing alert or stuff like that. And yeah, then I get it gets stressful, and I'm not doing that so much. I mostly do the squad lead, and for that it works good for me, and don't have problems with people doing what I say them, and yeah, it works like a good team.
I think I have only had 3 or 4 negative comments, but the first time I opened my mouth after the server combination on the leader chat, that was bad.
Oh yeah, the problem is I think I have more negative experience because I played in QTV. I think that had a lot to do with it, and we run nothing but public platoons. So you'd get random people and they're having no idea what the hell is going on, and they just start insulting you because they're stupid. And that was always a bit difficult, but I usually try to ignore a good amount of them. You have to just prove to people that you can play, and then they just shut up.
Yeah, well, I had one guy in one open platoon, and he said to me, I should get the shit out of here and play my Hello Kitty game. But then he left the platoon, so I did not respond to that guy, but yeah.
Uh-huh.
I mean, you have stupid people all around, and
most care that they much. Just say something and leave the platoon. You never get that chance to reply to them.
I have kind of ripped maybe a few assholes in platoon. I have kids, so I'm just one of these people. I don't take shit from people. So if someone starts talking shit in platoon, I will talk them down and just basically burn them. They'll have to go to the burn unit when I'm done with them. Because I don't care. You think you know shit? Good for you. Shut the fuck up. No one asked your opinion, basically. If you don't do that in our type of platoons, then people just... it gets out of control. Certain people... you have luck in certain outfits to where you have people who just won't do it because they're not morons. But when you have a bigger outfit, you have, unfortunately, the disadvantage of a lot of ass wipes at times. You just wonder, if you got nothing better to do than like bully a girl who's playing a game. Do you really need to? And is Yamik still alive?
I'm still alive, yes. Yes, I'm just listening.
Oh, make sure.
I'm watching at the chat, and... well, people who are watching, you can also, you know, ask questions. I'll
yeah, because we can see the stream.
Yeah, we could all see the stream, and we can all read comments and so on and so forth. So, you know, just if you care, you can ask questions, and they'll try to answer them if they find the question valid. And of course, get your misogyny out of the way quite quickly, okay? All the sandwich jokes go
and
away.
And Satriani needs to shut up.
Yeah, and then everything like that bullshit. So, you know. Let's see. Right, okay, well, maybe filling a little bit of time. Maybe some funny instances of platoon leading, or at least leading or playing while you have countered assholes, or just, you know, funny accidents, no?
I talk, but there's a fit going on in the background by me and waiting it out.
Okay.
The male nanny's not doing his job.
Okay.
Alright, stopped.
Alright.
Well, I sometimes abuse the fact that I'm female, because if I say in the platoon I'm lonely at the point, well, that's going to get me at least 10 people to the point.
You see, you're more feminine like that dwarf. I said, I'm lonely at the point. Get your asses up. Like, shut the fuck up. I usually say, if you get to the point, I won't tell your mom you
Meg
suck.
Here, I'll patch you up.
That's what I'll say. I'm good at
that. Well, okay. Inevitable question about great big Gamergate and Anita Sarkeesian. I'm not quite sure how well versed on the topic you three are. Of course, I sort of mentioned this topic before we started any stream a while ago. So, well, let's just say. Okay, fine. Let's start with a simple question. Does PlanetSide 2 has notable misogyny in it?
As in, like, sexism?
Sexism or women hating in this game. Would you say it's visible, or how is it visible, or even if it's
there? Are you talking about, like, in the community, like, interaction with other players?
No,
or just
the game
itself.
Game itself, as the game design.
The masses is kind of fat. I have to honestly say, the infiltrators, female infiltrators, have got some booty.
But, they do.
Yeah, they got some ass, don't they? That one's about, I mean, otherwise, they're just as equal. I'd have to say the only thing that kind of bugs me a bit are some of the female voice packs. They're either really girly or really butch. There's, like, not a nice middle ground that you can find. There's some really good ones that come up that are fun, but just the first NC, especially when you first log on to NC, the female. Oh my god, it's like a smurf.
The TR default isn't bad. I think
no.
It's nice.
That's really. The NC's the only one that's really ever stuck out to me as being overly chipmunky feminine. But otherwise, I think they did a good job in making the female characters equal in this game. I mean, they're not running around going, I broke a nail!
You know? Oh, come on.
Medic! I need my cuticles cleaned! You know, if they did something like that, I'd be like, what the hell is this? But it's pretty equal.
Well, yeah, I personally, I would say whenever I am playing, I don't care really, or I don't really distinguish who the fuck am I killing. When I get killed by somebody, yeah, of course I can barely, you know, tell which is which sex. But, you know, because the armor is basically clunky and you might as well just have one model for everyone. But, oh well. There's that. Unless, of course, you're playing with no helmet, which is the best purchase in the fucking game and the best idea SOE have ever come up with. But, you know, other than that, you can't really distinguish that much between the sexes in the game. After all, you're killing like thousands of them with one airstrike or something. There's that. Alright.
I've never ever thought about sexism in gaming, to be
honest. Yeah, that's the thing. I mean, I suppose some of you are maybe hardcore, others are more casual players and so on and so forth, but whenever I asked something about Anita Sarkeesian or Gamergate in both team speaks, that is either KOTVs or Orbs, not many. Basically any. There were maybe one or two guys that actually knew what was the topic all about. Which, in a way, sort of surprises me. But then again, yeah, that's just, you know, sort of social media stuff. And, you know, gamers are not always so social. Those of us who care, those will probably hear about these scandals and things like that. But, okay, well, comments on Anita Sarkeesian, I suppose. There were a question in the chat. So, question first of all is, do you know her? And what do you think of her? And, of course, of her work.
Well, I only know her because you mentioned her, so I have a look for her and watched her first video of her thingy, damsel in mistress thing and distress thing, and yeah, I don't know. I talked about it with my boyfriend and he was like all raging about her and like, oh, she's so awful and yeah.
I have watched the first one and some of them over the shoulder of my husband, but I think her examples are horrible. They never example the things she wants them to example.
I just see it this way.
She's cherry picking, first of all. That's my opinion only.
Well, she has a YouTube channel and she has a blog, so of course she's gonna address things that are gonna get attention quicker. She's not going to get to the... The thing I don't like about this female feminism and women in game, females are strong enough. You don't need to remind them they're weak. You don't need to tell them, well, look at this game doing your gender. And is it personally like pushing me down as a woman? No. That's just what kind of pisses me off. It's like, okay, fine. There's a damsel in distress, but we grew up with that. And just because it's damsel in distress doesn't mean we all think a man has to save us. We're not stupid. You know, and pointing that out as a female gamer is just going to make her be more hated because it's just kind of, it is cherry picking and it's annoying. I know. I all of us have probably seen a Disney movie or a romantic movie. That doesn't mean we're all like the people in the movies or in the Disney movies. It's a game. It's going to be visually interesting and stimulating because that's what people want to see. If you play the game...
And
yeah.
the men are not the princes on white horses either.
Yeah, they're not. It's all the time the women are saving the men and they don't know it. We secretly save you and you don't notice it. Mm. You know.
Of course, clean up after the man child. Of course.
No, like making you choose things that you don't want to choose without knowing that we're actually making you do it and you think you're doing it on your own.
Yes.
From my misogynistic point of view, I'm getting vibe that you have mind control devices specially designed to enslave the man.
They control you. Yeah. They're
okay.
Called
what is your next command?
you guys are slaves to your gender. We're not. You know how to rise above all that. Rise above.
Okay. Sure. No. Why not? Okay, there's an interesting question. Who do you think is the best of all you three in this game?
That's unfair to ask.
I know. Everybody. I know, but it's still, who is the best? I don't care in which, you know, part of the game.
I don't know. What question is it?
It's just a question from the list.
If somebody really wants to know that, then just look up our KDs then. That's the only way you're really going to get a consistency of who the best is. Because are they the best medic? Are they the best engineer? Are they the best commander? I mean, are you talking about all around? I mean, that's kind of vague. That's the problem.
You can't really go,
who's the best player? It's
Nanavi's the best medic on the whole server. She even beat men out. So, yeah. And it doesn't matter.
I have a horrible KD and it's never going to be over one.
The thing is, I like to think I'm not a shitty player. I basically do objectives. I get to the point, I get things done. I'm not afraid to get killed trying to get to the point. Because that is what you're supposed to do. I'm not a KD whore to where like, my KD, oh my god, no.
You know, it's just...
I could give two shits about my KD. I like teamwork.
I mean...
I like keeping people alive.
Yeah, there are people that, you know, say that worrying about my KD being up high or something like that keeps me, you know, entertained in the game. I've heard this argument from time to time, but to be honest, people who worry about their KD just don't enjoy the game the fullest, in my opinion. And
well, they do, but they play it for the wrong reasons.
Yeah, that's at least my point of view.
They want to be up on the leaderboards and they want to brag about it. I mean, that's fine.
Yeah, and usually they are not team players.
Yeah, they're the YOLO solo ones.
Much like me.
Well, you play Infiltrator. Although, I have to argue, just because you play Infiltrator doesn't mean you're not a team player. When I play Infiltrator, I infiltrate. I'll snipe sometimes, but I will go in, I'll hack the vehicle terminal, I'll put motion sensors down. That's what infiltrators are supposed to do, and half of them are just up in the hills doing nothing. It's a lot of amazing things you can do with an infiltrator.
And I have a stubborn way of playing because I don't change classes. I'm a medic, that's it.
Oh, for sure. I mean, I play infiltrator constantly. From time to time, I do delve into other classes, but I'm just so much used to the infiltrator. Whenever I play other classes, it's like, man, I wish I had my fucking cloak. I could do more. And that's the mentality behind my...
I always have the issue that after I've stopped playing my infiltrator, I'll be playing on a different class and I push F and I throw an ammo pack. I'm like, oh crap, wrong class. That one's always great. You feel like an idiot.
Yep.
Next question.
Let's see. What do we have here?
There's a lot of questions in chat. Look at them.
Yeah, I'm just taking a look.
Somebody, I believe Corsairs asked what made us start playing Planetside 2. Now there's a good question.
Oh, yeah.
I got your back, Corsairs.
Well, then maybe Sakria already start that one, so.
I was sitting on the sofa reading a book, and I noticed my husband was playing this game where he's shooting things, and I am a first-person shooter whore. I love first-person shooters. They're my favorite game. I'm not big on any other type of game. And I look, I'm like, what are you playing? He's like, Planetside 2. I'm like, does it cost $6 free? I'm like, okay, I'm in. That's how I got in KOTV, because he was in KOTV as well, and I just started playing with them. So I started playing Planetside 2 because it looked really interesting. I liked the multi-sided aspects of it, to where you don't have to just stick in one character. You can change. There's all kinds of different things to do there. You can fly. You can, you know, be in a tank. You know, all that's missing is submarines. No, but it's a lot of fun. It just made me start playing because I really liked the fact that it was a game I hadn't seen before. In that type
of
style.
She has submarines.
All right. Let's see. Ninov, then you.
How I started playing into? Because my husband wanted to play something together. So he wanted me to get my reflexes up. So that would be Planetside.
Oh, FPS games are the best for this, I think.
This is the first free reflex game I have ever played. Other games have always had a pause button, or they don't have time in this sense.
Yeah, you play enough like Unreal Tournament and Quake, and you
never.
You learn. Yeah. Oh, flak monkeys! I loved the flak cannon, and that was my thing.
Nina, Marilyn, your.
Yeah. Well, I think I got into game to my boyfriend because he played it and I saw it, and he was like, "Yeah, do you want to try it out?" And I'm, "Yes, sure." And yeah, after I start playing, he kind of stopped playing. Yeah,
mine too.
Mine too.
The game.
So misogyny at its best.
Yeah. Well, mine hasn't even reached Battle Lake 100 yet. He's really close to it, but he just can't be asked. GTA 5 came out, so you know.
Mine gotta be stopped when the 2CA went inactive.
I think my boyfriend stopped when he was about at rank 30 or something, and yeah, only me playing.
Alright, there's an interesting question about your FPS background, since Nina already said that she didn't play any FPS before. Then Sakura, you are next, then.
Yeah, name and I played it. I started out in 1998, playing Unreal Tournament in Quake. That's a long time ago, I know. Most of you were probably either sperm or babies in diapers, but... I started out playing Quake with my dad, and we followed that franchise, and then I got into Unreal Tournament. I was actually in a clan of Unreal Tournament, and played with them for about 2 years. And then after that, just pretty much any FPS that came out. I mean, like, I do kind of play Call of Duty, and whatever.
Everyone
things
did.
I can blow heads off. I'm not, I don't have any favorites. I just, if it comes out, I play it. Just how it is. This is the only game really so far that's captivated me for such a longer amount of time, but my first love is still and always will be Unreal Tournament.
Mine is
because,
Duke Nukem 3D, so I mean...
You know, Duke Nukem was alright, but Shadow Warrior, I did like Shadow Warrior a lot.
Or,
you gotta
didn't
love a
play
game
original.
Where someone says, oh, original Shadow Warrior, who wants us some wing? So I grew up with brothers as well, so I think that's kind of why I had a lot of first-person shooter interests. Because I played a lot of like war games with my brothers, and you know, I've always just been around guys, and it's fun. So yeah, if it's come out, I played it.
Alright, Marilyn, you're?
Yeah, I think I started playing kind of computer games with the Atari of my brothers, and playing Frogger or something like that for the first time, and then I got my Super Nintendo, where I played Super Mario and stuff like that, and then I basically played nothing for the next 10 years, and I think I only played Command & Conquer Red Alert for a couple of years, and I still play that, but other than
Command
that,
Command & Conquer
only,
has awesome music!
Yeah, it's so cool. And I only play Planetside besides that. I think I played Battlefield for one or two times, but I don't like it that much.
I never liked battlefield. Oh, no, well. Let's see. There was one good question. Fuck's sakes, this chat.
Your brain.
Yeah, right. Let's see.
Oh, by the way, I play NC usually.
Someone asked that. Sakura is basically Vano, or used to be Vano, because she plays at Terran.
Well, Vano is Battle Rank 100, and I hate objectives.
Yeah, exactly.
I'll farm those when I get really bored. So
yeah,
Battle
like
Rank 100, Vano, and Battle Rank 62 TR.
Oh yeah, and Ninav is
and 12 NC.
So basically, yeah, we have joined your channel.
One of each faction.
So that's kind of nice. User was moved out of your channel. All right. Well, let's see. How do you feel about other factions? Well, simple question. As you started playing, and now.
I might have gone Vano if the color scheme wasn't colorblind unfriendly.
Purple. Yeah.
Yeah, but I can't tell blue and purple apart, and I can't see red, so I had to be red to shoot the other two that I can't tell apart.
That's a good idea. As far as factions go, I'm really enjoying TR at the moment. I kind of like them all, but Vanu's getting on my nerves lately. I'm really starting to hate Vano because of voiced in previous streams why, but I don't know. I think nothing farms like NC, as in when you're playing against NC. I don't get as many kills as I do when I'm going after NC. It's just like yum 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 certs. It's just, I don't know why. It's not NC's fault. I think there's just a lot of people who kind of aren't as experienced on NC. Not all of them, but I noticed that's like the most popular starter faction, I kind of get the feeling. For a while, NC was recommended for a really long time, so there were so many people joining on NC. But I'd have to honestly say that it would go TR, NC, Vano with my love for outfit, like factions. I know.
Well, yeah, I still remember back in the day on at least release at Woodman, NC definitely had overpop. The time passed and Vano became more populated, but still, we at most times were underpopped. So that's kind of interesting. Let's see.
I can't hit anything with NC weapons. Nothing. Yeah.
NC weapons
I only
are
use
really
it
good.
Because it's I like blue, so I think I would go with the NC. But I have a Vano character on another server, but I don't play it that much, to be honest. It's only my kind of backup character if Miller isn't working or something. And I have never played TR besides one server smash where we have to play it.
Alright, speaking of weapons, there was a question. What is your favorite weapon?
TRV. Oh, from Vano, the HV-47, 45.
Oh, that one, yes.
Yeah.
I like my Gauss Compact S, and I like my Heartstring, but only because it shoots hearts, and not because it's pretty useful, but yeah.
I have the crossbow with the skill. I like that one. Let me think.
I like C4.
Well, C4 I love as well, yes. C4 is very good. I am heavily enjoying the NS-11A on my medic. I really love that gun. NS weapons in general, NS-15, NS-11C, but probably, I don't know, there's no specific weapons. I'm kind of one of those people who goes through a lot of weapons. I don't have a lot of axioms on weapons, because no kidding, I switch weapons like I do underwear. I just want to try different weapons to see how they shoot, and VR testing it out a little bit's not enough for me, so I'll trial them. If I like it, I buy it, and I just switch around, because I like different guns for different situations. But I do, yeah. I'm not a favoritist, it's just, if it works, it works. I know your typical weapons for TR.
All right. Let's see. Yeah, right. I keep forgetting the question. All right, fine. Just a reminder to whoever's watching, you know, you can send in questions and I'll try to ask them, and so on and so forth. Let's see. I suppose Sakura here is the most vocal of all three, at least in the community. otherwise, I would say. So
she's got the biggest mouth.
I would simply say the most vocal. But yeah. What annoys you the most from the community, at least when you're, and I crashed.
No.
Yeah. All right, you can. Fuck, you can still keep talking, but I'll try to get back in the game and so on and so forth. But yeah, you know, the question is quite obvious. What's the most annoying thing you have encountered while dealing with the community as a rather vocal people?
Server rep and that kind of stuff?
Yeah, you can, you know, tell one of your stories.
The most annoying I've had so far have been at server smash meetings, to where when we first merged with Miller, I came in as a Woodman rep. I was basically Server Smash Woodman rep from the start of Server Smash with Darth Sidious and Anger. And we came over as reps, and I don't know, just the whole idiotic, oh, you're a girl thing again kind of came up, but some of the outfits just think they're better than you and look down on you. And I just don't like being looked down on. And I kind of got the feeling that there were a few choice outfits that think I'm useless. And I still get that feeling from them. And that really annoys me, because they don't know me, they don't play with me in game, so they can kiss my ass just because I'm female, or just because I don't know something off the top of my head. I have children, they suck my brain power out of my head. I have like 50 things in the house going, I'm multitasking, sometimes even while I'm sitting there giving out accounts or doing Server Smash stuff, I have a 3-year-old next to me drooling on my arm going, mama, mama, mama. I want to see them do that stuff. And that's the most irritating, it's just the fact that people don't think you're up to the job, you know, because, oh, it's a man's game, it's strategy, you gotta be able to read maps, and you gotta know tactics. Only, you know, intelligent people know tactics. You're like, yeah, you know, because I'm not intelligent, you know, because I don't think like you, then I must not be intelligent, or because I look at things differently. That's very, very annoying. It's just, I know that so far in Server Smash, there's been one female, one, who attempted to get Force Command on the server. She didn't get it. You have to vote Force Command in for Server Smash, and she put her name forward, and they picked the guy. I give her, you know, big, big balls for actually putting her name in, because that's a big responsibility. But it's just kind of, I want to see, that's what I want to see happen next. I want to see a female Force Commander in Server Smash. But it probably won't happen, because I think, I don't know how you guys feel, but you feel a little bit more put under pressure when you lead, because you don't want to think people, you're stupid, because you're female. Oh, you don't know the game, look at the mistakes they're making, you know? Because you put a little bit more under the, you know, microscope when you play. Like, when the magnifying glass, they look at you closer because, well, let's see if this chick knows to play this game or she's just dumb. You know? Mm-hmm. So
there's a question. Sakura, can you give an example of people being idiots like that? Specific
in, like,
example.
I don't want to give examples, because then I'm not one to name names. I don't like doing that.
Right. The last stream...
That's why I don't want to. The last stream, I named it because I knew for a fact and I dealt with it for a long time.
Yeah, yeah.
And I also, at this point, I'd like to say to Warcore, I'm sorry I didn't know everything, but as the video on Reddit shows this afternoon, I kind of was right. But, you know, they do their tactics. They do train. Even if they drop on the wrong base, they do train. But... Yeah.
All right. Let's see. There was what would be your suggestion for let's say any girl, woman either thinking about playing this game or even starting to platoon lead in this game?
What should they do?
Well, suggestions how to maybe deal with people or you know, basic suggestions or advice.
You don't really have to learn how to deal with people. The first thing I'm going to teach you is read the map. Learn to read the map. Set the filters up properly. That will make, if you learn to read the map and understand the map and the lanes and the lattice system, that is the most important part if you are looking to lead, in my opinion.
Yeah, people you can just ignore.
Yeah, ignore the dumb people, do you think? You know it better and you learn with every time you lead. You should start with squad lead and then look what your platoon leader is doing and then you platoon lead at some point. And yeah, you need to talk to the people, that's what I get all the time. The more you talk, the better it works.
Yeah.
It's hard for the first time and start platoon leading the first 5 minutes, I'm totally fucked up nervous. Don't know what to say. I'm so, oh gosh, I hope I don't mess it up. But after that, you talk and it will work. And if people don't like the way you play, they go and leave the platoon and other people will drop in and the other people like how you play and like how you lead. And well, the more you lead, the more you get into it and the more you get better.
Yeah, all right. Then there was a question, how are you treated in your respective outfits?
Excuse me. Well, now good. When I first started out, not so good.
What do you mean? Come on.
Curry is not a friendly
right,
person.
Oh, right, okay, withdrawn.
He's creepy and he's really unfriendly. He'll ask you if you have a sister, and I mean, in the beginning it was very difficult to stick around KOTV because Curry made it very uncomfortable. Very uncomfortable. But,
I never had problems in Mu, but when I joined Mu, I didn't have a working mic in 3 months or something like that. So they really didn't know I'm a female. I can
heal you. It was hidden.
Merlin?
I never had problems in Orbs, to be honest. They are all pretty nice guys.
Yeah,
and yeah, I don't know, in Gods, where I was before, it was the same. Honestly, they are all pretty nice and help you out if you need something, so they are all pretty nice. I mean, sure, you get some flappy comments and, I don't know, stuff like that, but you have to respond like the same, and it's good. I would not play in an outfit if I don't like the people that I'm playing with, so. I mean, I only play that game because of the people in the outfit I am, and I like them, so. Yeah.
I have to say, I am an EDT as well, and they do treat me fairly, even if it's all about nipples.
Alright.
It's always about the nipples.
It is, it's Gav's nipples. They're the holy shrine.
Potatoes.
You don't follow much on EDT, do you?
No.
It's a running
thing. Why would you?
Out of the loop.
Why would I? Okay, the question is, how do you feel about team killing and trolling in squads or platoons?
Hey. It's annoying.
I don't condone team killing.
Yeah. Well, the only time that we've ever done any type of team killing is when someone hijacked a platoon.
And condoning team killing. Now, that's a new one.
Well, the only time that we've actually actively said kill someone with team killing was only like once or twice when people hijacked a platoon and would not give it back with the name. And that's the only time that I've ever actually done that. But otherwise, it's kind of like you do it, you're out, you're annoying, go away. Because especially if you're in a situation where you're trying to get something done and you've got someone trolling everybody and team killing, it just completely distracts everyone. So thank goodness there's the ban from platoon thing now.
Well, there are a few Mu members that have a standing order to team kill Gav on site, but that's the only thing.
Yeah, EDT kind of does that as well.
Yeah.
Someone just mentioned that in straight, like, wait, we don't team kill in Mu? No, it's okay, she mentioned it, you just calm down.
Oh, there's an interesting thing. What's the rudest, or at least the most obscene, funniest insult you've ever gotten? And no sandwich jokes, come on. I mean, by misogyny standard.
I had once a guy who sent me a picture of his penis.
What?!
And that was not a good picture.
To your game.
No.
Oh my god, the fact that he sent, did you have to get the magnifying glass out?
Kinda.
Wow.
It was, yeah.
You don't
send
pictures of that unless it's something worth looking at. I mean, seriously.
That's true. That's true.
If it's under 7, guys, don't send dick pics. Don't do that. He's gonna look bad. I think, actually, the meanest I've ever been treated was by a fellow TR player. Stumpy Cat. I said something in proximity, and he told me to shut the fuck up and go back to my mom, because he thought I was a teenage boy. Surprise, surprise, Stumpy Cat being mean. But, and then the other one was someone told me I was a cunt and I needed to go back, do my womanly things and stuff like that, in platoon no less. Not just in a tell or something like that, but in proper platoon, he yelled it at me.
Oh, that sucks.
Yeah. If you're a strong woman, you got a big mouth and an opinion, then you better be expecting people saying stupid shit. So I was like, alright, good for you, now piss off. Take you and your small penis and go back home.
And then he sent me the picture, probably. Of his penis.
I really don't remember the mean things said to me. Only that there's usually the person asking inquiry that, are you a girl or a little boy? That's it.
Right. There was a question a little while ago. Why are teenage or, you know, younger, people, I would say, both genders, hated so much? At least your opinion, what would be?
Well, Sammy Wills gives him a bad name.
Yep, fuck that piece of shit.
I'm friends with the big game, I have no problem
Sammy.
With Sammy Wills.
Sammy has never done anything
no,
bad.
No, you no, no, he's just a fucking cunt.
I think the only thing I think is just immaturity sometimes in game is fun, but in certain situations it gets really annoying, and I think they kind of connect that with the fact that they're younger. But it's the internet, it's to be expected. I don't think the teenagers in general, I think it's just trolls in general that people get irritated by.
I think the younger people tend to talk more. They tell what they are doing and ask things and tell again what they are now doing. That irritates people.
Still remember in KOTV we had a very young lad, I think 12 or so, and he had very squeaky voice, and he tried to lead the platoon and so on and so forth. He did, I guess, okay, but people simply didn't seem to respond as well to his
orders.
You
mean KOTV was mean? I've never heard of
anything like that.
No,
not KOTV, but just people in the platoon. It was an open platoon, after all. And people just didn't seem to respond to him as well as to other leaders. That was rather, you know, discouraging for a lad. But you know, then again, you know, that's a kid, so fuck all kids.
I'm curious to see what they can get up to in game as well.
Oh yeah, yeah. All right, let's see. Maybe any topics you would like to discuss, because, you know, people are not constantly asking everything. Let's see.
Your mom,
what?
How's she doing?
Yeah. Your mama.
What, I can't ask how your mom's doing? We're talking about women here. Your mom's important? I see how it is. You know Mother's Day's coming up, right, Yamix? Don't you forget it.
Another pointless day, in my opinion. Then question is, why isn't there, you know, such celebration when it's Father's Day and
there
things
is
like that?
Father's Day.
There is,
there is,
but
a
I'm, I said, why isn't there such
Germans
celebration?
Germans celebrate Father's Day the best way they know how, and that's with a Bollerwagen behind a beer.
Yeah, I suppose. But
they seriously walk around getting drunk all day. That's Father's Day. Now that's a man's day.
I don't know.
Get in fights in the park.
Well, I don't know.
Questions from us?
Okay.
I don't know.
Let's see.
No, it's gone. Never mind. My brain was like, no.
There's a question about accepting a mature younger person. The Mu has few leaders that are 15 and 16, and they are one of our best leaders. And they are the only 15 and 16 persons in that outfit.
Yeah, you can't really judge leadership abilities by age. Some people are a bit more mature and more into it. I mean, you can't just go, oh, you're too young, bro. It doesn't work like that.
Yeah.
I don't think Mech Boy, technically, Mech's a good leader,
and he's pretty young. Sorry, if there's anyone younger in KOTV, I can't think of anyone that leads and is young.
Alright, there's a rather unconclusive question for anyone to ask, but do most females run in squads or lone wolf type of thing? I mean...
What do you mean by, like,
yeah.
Do you go out on the prowl, all women in one squad?
Ladies night! We're gonna rip our axes up!
As in, like, do we prefer playing solo or in squads?
Well, yeah, I would ask that question to you personally, not as a gross generalization, as you can't really answer the question for every single person in the world.
Well, there's three of us here, so we could each answer for ourselves.
Yeah, exactly. So,
all
right. Go for that.
I'm mostly playing outfit squads. Or random open squads. I'll get you
fixed. Yeah, I prefer playing in a squad. I'll only solo really when I'm flying or sniping.
I think I never play solo. I only play in squads or platoons, yeah. But I mostly join squads where I know the people who are playing. Don't have to be orbs squads or something, but yeah, I usually play with people I know.
Hmm.
So
there you go, we're
quite
all
a lot
players.
With randoms. Yeah, and the other females that I do know, I think they tend to play in squads.
All the females I knew who played Curry chased them off. I'm not joking.
Actually, no. Death Bell still somewhere around, I think.
Do you see? She was. She played only heavy, though.
Oh.
I seriously only ever saw her as a heavy. But. Well, most female players, you don't know they're female because of the fact that a lot of them,
don't talk.
Yeah, they're scared to.
Yeah, that was another question I wanted to ask. Why would you think that, you know, female players are more scared to talk? I can heal you. In whatever.
I wonder why.
Yeah.
Are you a boy or a girl?
Yeah.
How big are your boobs? Do you have a picture of yourself?
What do you wear when you're playing?
Misogyny at its best.
Exactly! I wear a lot of shit when I play because I get fucking cold. A sweater, fluffy socks, leggings, a lot of clothes. I'm just in my panties and underwear here just honing some noobs. Oh my god. Please, what are you guys playing? Jesus, clothes! Let me get my ball gown out and go, you know, sniping. Jesus. Oh, such dumb stuff.
Yeah.
Yeah,
although I've heard from some people that I've heard from males that they play in their boxes. I'm like, dude, too much information.
Ash chicken that he will share.
Oh no, shh, no. I don't want to hear nothing from chicken.
Yeah.
Oh, wait, hold on. I need to do a shout out. Hulky! Sorry.
Oh yeah, Hulky, Hulky.
Hulky!
Where the fuck is that Asa? Come on. Haven't seen him in a while.
Alright, back to the subject. Yes. Yeah.
Oh, this is a good one. Osama's one big bro sent in. Ladies, what is your opinion on male players playing female?
Let me heal you. Creeps. I get a feeling that they're just always trying to get angles on that ass. Like, looking at the ass and the, like, turning their player. I always just get that feeling. And plus, if they give their female player a female name as well, like Cheeky Girl 69. It's like, fine for them if they're gonna play a female character, but I don't know.
Maybe they like it, I don't know.
They like watching them
run. Never thought of that.
Well, no, I still remember a couple of my friends, or at least one explicitly, have said, you know, I play female because I want to look at that booty. Honestly, it was like, Dude.
And he's still a virgin. If you're looking at ass in video game, go out and see real women. Good God. They won't bite you. Go to a damn games convention. You'll meet chicks there who play games.
Oh yeah, that's the most puzzling thing to me. Actually, you go to games conventions and basically there are tons of chicks in slutty costumes of
The slutty costume stuff. It's not slutty costumes. It's cosplaying.
Fine. So slutty costumes. By my standards is cosplay. What the fuck?
Fine, Yamix, by my standards, if you're wearing a wife beater and shorts, then you're wearing slutty clothes. You take your shirt off at the beach, you must be a slut, Yamix. They dress like that. It's how they're dressing like that, because that's how the games are. They're dressing up like the characters in the games.
Oh, okay.
Never paid attention to the player tractor genders. I have no idea what gender my outfit mates play.
They're always male when I play. If they are female, it's very rare to see a male playing a female.
I have two friends that play females.
Whenever I run around and, well, when occasion comes and I have a brain hemorrhage and I start playing MMORPGs.
Hemorrhage?
Yeah. You know, I start playing MMORPGs, there are tons of these people, so, you know, maybe it's just me noticing these kinds of things, but whatever. It's just me. Alright, so that's that. Question, there was a while ago. What would be the best thing for Plantside to change, at least in, you know, let's say next month? What would be the best thing for Plantside to be changed? Let's say, aspect of the game that must be changed to improve the overall quality.
Bring the old alerts back!
I want territory to mean something.
Alright, yeah, I would agree on the old alerts for sure. I'd say content alerts.
Fix the damn squad deploy!
Oh yes! Instant redeploy.
All the deploy stuff is not working pretty good.
Oh bravo. Bravo Daybreak. Still managed to break something.
It's in the name.
They break games. What the fuck were they thinking when they made it?
They wanted to break games.
So apparently.
That's like Ubonics right there. They break games. They break some. That's what it is. See, they breaks games. Bad English.
They have a choice for a name, I guess.
I suppose. Oh, and there's a good question from the last stream I still asked. What is the best thing added to this game since release, or since whenever you started playing, in your opinion?
Oof. Triage healing maxes. I can heal maxes.
Oh, yeah. Fuck. Nice.
Yeah, I like the fact that you can deploy in galaxies directly. Squad deploy in galaxies, that's nice. And Hossen, maybe.
Oh god, don't start him on Hossen. He'd sing you a song about his love for it. I would have to say Stalker Cloak.
For me, I still stick to my answer, which is directives. But, yeah.
Stalker Cloak's fun because you can just troll the shit out of people with it.
Oh yeah.
You can get knife directives and crossbow directives done a lot easier with it as well.
Yeah, for sure. Yeah, so guys, just, you know, keep on sending in questions, I'll try to ask them and so on and so forth. Alright, what could we ask else? God damn it, I'm running out of ideas.
I play a female character because it's nicer to hear them shouting in the same gender voice.
Yeah, because you might be a bit confused when you're shouting as a man again.
Yeah.
What the fuck?
Yeah,
That's the worst part in server smashes.
Yeah, I imagine you are running around with a dude who has throat cancer.
Oh, there's no female characters whatsoever in server smash. All males. And all white. It's racist and it's sexist.
Oh, that's true. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Why they gotta be white, huh?
It's racist and misogynistic.
Now we got to the topic that Emblemic wanted us to talk about.
Alright, alright, question, how do you feel about the Black Hand? The new pistol thingy. Like it? Dislike it?
Me?
No idea.
I haven't
that's
bought it.
That's the one that's basically like the commissioner.
Yeah.
But with four shots. Yeah. And
but
even
just bigger.
Way fucking louder if that's possible. I trialed it and I wasn't that disappointed with it, but I don't see the point in it. To be honest, It's okay. I mean, it does have the scope on it directly, where you can put the scopes on the commissioners and all that's actually quite cool, but I mean, for the amount of station cash for it, it's really not worth it.
Yeah, if I want to spend station cash on stuff, I usually do it for helmets or camos or stuff like that.
Yeah,
well, you need
we
to
should
ask us that. How many helmets and camos we have? I have so many.
I have so many camos.
I know! So everybody always gets in my cases, like, it's your woman. I'm like, and so what? I want to accessorize and kick ass.
Yes!
The helmets are hard to resist. You're like, that one would look good with that camo.
Yeah, I switched it up from time to time.
I barely play this NC character. Let me see how many helmets.
Oh,
I
speaking of
have.
NC, I just simply hate how NC helmets look. Just nothing good.
Oh come on, my helmet looks
nothing good.
NC helmets are pretty cool. They've gotten better over the last couple of months as well.
I don't like
the Vanu ones.
NC
have gotten
helmet.
Uglier.
Yeah, Vanu for sure. Just. Ugly after ugly after
starting
ugly.
Starting to look really weird. I have ten helmets
server.
On this character and I barely ever play it.
Test server helmet looks good, but nothing else doesn't.
Yeah, I like my helmet, but I don't like this helmet where you can't see a part of the face. I really don't like that. Don't know why, but... like to
it makes
see...
no sense in a battle situation.
Yeah.
Put this over my face so I can't see. Alright, let's go.
I'm
the opposite. I don't like seeing any of the face. I don't
I
want to get my makeup
my
messed up.
I
don't
how my character looks like in a year, I think. She has been looking the same for the most of the time I play.
I always have scary. I like the scary masks. That's probably the old goth in me.
I mean, I run around with Viper, so. That's
that one is an awesome helmet.
That's fantastic. The best one in the game. I'm
although, just... I do like the TR one with the skull on the front of it.
I like the Stormtrooper one. That's just ridiculous.
That's pretty much EDT's. All the heavies in EDT wear those.
Yeah, it's just ridiculous.
The Daka Daka helmets. I have that one as well. Surprise, surprise.
Yeah.
I have the Arctic something is the name of one of the helmets I have on my engineer. It's like a front helmet with a hood. Kind of like the one I have on my light assault on here, but a little bit different. And as far as camos go, oy vey. 30 of them maybe?
Alright, that's an interesting question. Do you think you are as emotionally competitive as male gamers?
Shit, yeah.
I'm personally, I think I'm less competitive than Sakura, because I just frankly don't give a shit. I just like to either be an asshole in the game by, you know, sniping people off the vehicle terminals and so on and so forth.
I don't do that. If I snipe you, you're gonna be running, flying, or trying to shoot somebody. I'm not gonna get you when you're standing still. That it's not just really fairness, it's skills. I wanna build my skills up, but if I'm always shooting at people who are standing still, I'll never get better. You know, I like setting that limit with sniping. Same with fucking flying. I hate air-to-air lock-ons. I hate them so much.
How?
And I do not use them. I hate them. They're shitty because you better. No. Air to air. Seriously, how often does it happen? A battle rank 10 flies up behind me with air to air lock ons. I'm having a good fight with another pilot who doesn't have air to air lock ons, and the punk ends it with this shitty rocket.
It's a valid way to kill someone.
Valid, but you're if you depend on a lock on, then you never get good with aim.
Fine, whatever. Be a tryhard.
I play too much server smash as well. I just don't think it's fair. I don't like air-to-air lock-ons. They're absolute shit. and I
yeah, they
not
are.
Like people
in comparison
to
coyotes, I would say that they are basically
hellfires?
Very hard to use.
I love my hellfires.
Yeah, I even tend to dogfight with lol pods constantly, which I from time to time actually manage to win. But yeah, that's on that side. I suppose I can see why air-to-air lock-ons are bad, but frankly, they are balanced enough. Sure, you
yeah,
ain't gonna...
But if everybody just uses air-to-air lock-ons, then like I said, the skill will never progress. We all just be lock-on monkeys. You know, never really learn to fight in the air with each other, you know, except for looking forward and making sure your lock-on's on. You're so much more aware when you don't use the lock-ons because you have to maneuver.
Alright, well, let's see, there was a question. Do you take any measures to preserve your KD or any other stat you have?
No.
I don't give a shit about stats and KD.
The only measure I take is when I fly in that flight assault. Because most of the time I will use it as... I'll fly in after a Sunday, I'll hellfire it, I'll use my first weapon, and then I'll get really close, and then I'll bail out of the Mozzie, slam the Mozzie into the Sunday, be a light assault, and throw C4 on it. That's one of the tactics I like to use. That's the only reason I have the light assault. So they can be like, yeah, I killed the Mozzie, boom, your Sunday's dead, screw you.
I have a horrible hand-eye coordination, so if I were to care about my KD, it would be bad for me.
I think I only have a good KD if I do something like Battle Sundays or something like that. Usually when I play
Medic
or something, I don't get a good KD, so... And I never play Infiltrator, so, yeah.
Oh, well, you're missing.
When I'm an Infiltrator, on average, it's around 2 to 3. One day I had 11, which was awesome, but that's because it was all NC lined up. It was like shooting fish in a barrel. It was awesome. But yeah, that's the highest it's ever been, non-vehicle KD. But I don't. I'll see it and I'll go, wow, cool, and then I'll die like 10 times and it's gone. And it's awesome and all, but I just don't really care as much about it as other people do.
Yeah, starting my FPS games well in month 30, it's never going to be good.
Yeah.
Well, personally, the only time I have tried doing anything to preserve kind of stats I have is. I stopped using our axioms after using especially sniper rifles, as I take pride in at least how efficient I can be with the sniper rifle. Because the last sniper rifle I our axiom was V10, and that had 90 something percent of headshot ratio, and yeah, kind of proud of that at least.
Pets on the backs.
It was just fun for me to do and try to do my best on at least, you know, all those types of weapons as I, you know, get into sniping a lot. Right. There's an interesting thing I just want to ask. In three words, describe each class in the pun side.
What?
In three words or less, describe
each class.
Infantry class.
What is this, a fucking test?
Just,
medic.
You know, just just for the fun of it, you know?
All of them.
Heal,
medic.
Revive, repeat.
That's a good one.
That's good.
That's a good one.
And if I never play anything else, do I have to participate on the other classes?
I don't think she should have to, that's only fair. You describe the classes that you play.
Alright, fine. That's good enough.
I got a good one for Infiltrator.
Yeah, go.
Surprise butt sex. Because that's usually what happens, they're just behind you and they get you from behind.
Yep.
And let's see. Light assault. Surprise C4 sex? I don't know. Surprise boom, you're dead? I don't know.
C4 fairy. I say C4 fairy, that's it.
But that's not three words.
C4 fairy.
No.
Three.
Nah.
No, that's a letter, a number, and a word.
Nitpicky.
Flying C4 fairy. Better?
Engineer?
I
need repairs. It's pretty much something else.
Max's little bitch.
As EDT likes to call them, butlers.
Big butlers.
Your butler. Let's see, heavy. Boom, shield up.
Ivan shield, yeah. Oh no, wait, I have no skill.
Ooh.
That's what I would say about heavies.
Max is, I can't cap. <It's> basically it. I'm gonna get a Max to the point. Fuck, no one else is here. Son of a bitch.
My take on Max would be big fat fuck. That's about it.
You're inside of him though.
Well, yeah.
TRS. Big tin can.
Yeah. Alright, there was a question also. Would you consider Commissioner being a direct upgrade for Faction Pistol? Or pistols? Personally, I would say that this person is completely delusional. Faction for
loud.
NC, yes. For NC, it might.
You cannot
put
anything on it. You might as well just put a big bullseye in your head when you fire it.
Exactly.
If you're using it as a secondary weapon because you can't reload, fine. But if you are actively using a Commissioner as an infiltrator and looking to stay unseen, it is the dumbest weapon to use. Because they kaboom, kaboom, there you are on the map, and they can pretty much guess where you're at. The same with, I have stuff on that glows now, but on my actual characters, I don't wear anything, like any type of lighting or anything, because if you uncloak, like I said in the damn Idiots of Araxis, you uncloak and you're a target. How often is it that I'm up in a tower, and I'm sniping, and I see someone uncloak, and I'm like, or I see someone running around the anniversary, the anniversary stuff that glows, because my brain's not functioning right now. And it's just
things
that,
you have now.
Yes, that the thing that I have on. Yes, and you can pick them off so easily. I don't play this character much, so that's why. All my other ones, I don't. You can't really help it with some characters like the infiltrator. There's no real choice with that. You glow, but actively putting even more glowing on your butt is just bad. I mean, that's Commissioner's good if you want to be. If it's for, like, your second-class weapon on one of your other characters besides Infiltrator. And to be honest, in my opinion, there's better secondary weapons than the Commissioner for factions.
Well, yeah. As for Commissioner and Faction Pistols, Beamer and Repeater are the best pistols in the game. Desperado is the number 3. Beamer is number 2, Repeater is definitely outright the best.
I'm trying to remember the one I'm using on TR right now. I love it, and I look at the name of it all the time, but my brain's going, no. That's the one that's basically, has very rapid fire, has about 20 shots. The T-something.
T-amp?
Yeah, it's a secondary.
A fully automatic, eh?
Yes.
Yeah, that pocket SMG number 2. Pocket SMG number 2, basically.
I really am enjoying that.
It's worse than the default, but it's still fucking good. So.
No, if you're running around as an infiltrator with that weapon, it's a quick succession. You can get them down very fast, recloak, and then, you know, regroup where you're going next.
Oh, for sure. So I suppose that's your... Well, there was a question also related to this. What is your favorite pistol or secondary?
That one!
Yeah, exactly. So, Marilyn...
For a while, it was my crossbow, but then I got tired of it.
Appreciate it. I still love my heartstring.
Me too. I love my heartstring.
I don't have... That's how manly, girly I am. You guys got the heartstrings one, and I got the skull one.
Yeah, I got
so
the Blackheart.
So I don't get sweetheart when I got it. I got hater. And I actually like that.
It's okay.
I like
I'm
skulls.
Never gonna get the sweetheart.
It's only 50
yes,
or 60.
Yeah, it's very easy. You run with the infiltrator, that's it.
It's patience is the problem. It's the patience of killing that many people, and it works best as an infiltrator, and you just... Eventually, I think it's only 60, it feels like forever, though. What you do is, you know, you take a shot, and then you go... I just lost my brain. Because somebody... Who is that? Is that fucking Moo? Is that Phantom talking in proximity?
Yeah, that's Phantom.
Yeah.
What the fuck? I'm getting squished by a galaxy.
Alright, let's see, there was also, your take on Underboss,
never used it.
It's like number 5 in the whole pistol-less.
Underboss, but basically just the commissioner, but smaller.
It's faster, therefore bigger DPS, and I'd say
and
underboss
just
is certainly
fucking
better.
Loud.
Yeah, exactly. So, underboss better than commissioner, although I do like to say the commissioner is aesthetically pleasing more. As you can actually say that you're using your big black cock in battle or something.
Hey, say that in a room full of women, that's a good idea, Yamix.
Well, it's just one of the jokes about the weapon I've heard over the years.
I'm sure you've heard it, yeah?
Yeah. Right, whipping pin out, everything to me. But, you know, misogyny has to be somewhere after all.
And it comes from you. The irony of it.
And fine, I'll ask that fucking question. Would any of you consider being a voice actor for machinima or a thing like that?
What do you mean?
Like what?
There was a question.
Voiceovers?
That, yeah, voiceovers or something like that. I don't.
Bitch, I've done voiceovers.
Yeah, exactly.
What the hell do you think Idiots of Araxes is?
Exactly. So guys, if you don't know what that is, you can check it on my channel. There is blah blah blah. Whatever.
I suggested the Fashion Police one, damn it.
Yeah, exactly. That was your idea. And your idea also was about, does this camo look fat? Make
does
me look
camo
fat.
Make my butt look big, yeah.
Yeah, that was just good. Anyways, Nina or Merlin, your thoughts on the topic of being voice acting for something.
I hate having my voice recorded. It's horrible trying to listen to it afterwards.
Yeah.
Having to
yeah,
read
that's
it again.
What I've that's what I've been dealing ever since the beginning of my channel, you know.
Whenever I listen to my voice, I'm thinking, God damn it, they are right, I do sound like a man. That's what I always say. I'm like, you do not sound like a woman. You're inferior.
Yeah, because you have heard the thingy I did for the Pro 7 competition. It was horrible recording that.
I think, it was a while ago, so I might not remember it correctly, but yeah, it was like, yeah, that's Pro 7 for you. So, what can I say? Fuck Pro 7, besides that, you know. But that's just my opinion, of course. There's an interesting question about sexual stereotype, basically. Female gamers...
It would be cool if you can do your voice as your voice packet for the game. So you
yes,
can have
mine?
Your voice. That would be really
I
cool.
So I would like to have one to get the fuck out the way.
Yeah, I actually would say that Sakura should
be beep,
definitely
beep,
get one.
Yeah, get your shit together!
Get the fuck out the way!
So if anyone from Recursion is watching, you know, just poke Sakura.
Hal from EDT is making actually a voice pack, and I think one of mine is something like a troll killer. So I forget exactly which one he took. I think it's something to do with medics. So he was working on that. I wonder if he'll ever get it done. He took like a bunch of voice clips from people from EDT and was making it into a voice pack. Yeah, but if you could customize your voice pack like that, you know it would be just trolling.
Yeah.
That would be so bad.
Yeah. Alright, let's see. There was a question about women's stereotypes, basically, that women play mostly support roles in Dota, LoL, and Plantage. Do you think that women nowadays are breaking more of the stereotype that, you know, women play these types of things mostly?
Well, wasn't the question he asked kind of like...
Yeah, I know, maybe the person didn't
If we always play the supportive roles in games because that's what we like to do kind of thing? Or... I see it this way, as far as it goes with this game, you have a fucking gun, it's an equalizer. That's not supportive, that's shooting you in the face. So this game is definitely good.
Yeah, you can shoot and help people.
Yeah. Oh, I killed you, sorry, let me res you. But, I mean, this game especially, I think there's nothing sexist in this game.
That's true.
Yeah.
It's equal.
I would just laugh in the face of any fucking stupid feminist who would point out they're sexist in this game. This game barely has anything in it.
You're nitpicking. And yeah, if you're looking just... for sexism, here's the thing. You wanna attack something sexist-wise, attack porn, for Christ's sakes. Go after that. A video game, the thing is with porn, it gives men a very, very wrong idea of how sex actually is. And they think it needs to be all these things that is not usually. It's like, I compare it to the special effects porn. Basically, it's like when you watch action movies, you don't want to see, like, boring police chases and, like, little poofs of smoke. You want explosions, you want shit going boom and cars flying through the air. Same with porn. You just don't want to watch two people laying under a bedsheet having sex. You want to see it go and get, you know, you want to see them have fun. And that's what I think. If you want to address something, address the fact that you're giving some men the wrong idea of how to treat women sexually. That is something. But in a fucking video game? No. Come on. You know, I mean, that's how I explained porn to my son. He's like, I said, why can't I watch porn at my age? He's 11. I said, because you would not understand that that's not exactly how it always goes. And I used the action movie metaphor and he got it. It is kind of true.
It is true, yeah.
So, I mean, that would be more sense. That's the whole thing I have with feminism. You don't attack porn because women are in it. Women have sex too. Attack it because they're making women look like sluts all the time. And or that they just make it look like that women are down for anything. No, that's a bunch of bullshit. You know, yeah. So yeah, making everything sexist is just
ridiculous. Mostly it's nitpicking and just bullshit.
Well, if you look at games like League of Legends, a lot of females like the female characters in League of Legends because they think they're cute. You know?
Yeah.
They like their outfits, they like the way they look.
In League of Legends, actually, they are just making them way more sexualized than I would ever do. Of course, not all characters, but some of them are just calm.
As much as some feminist women try to say, I would never play that character, they would. They'd be like, oh my god, she's so cute, I love her hair, I love this about her. And it's just a game.
Yeah.
That's exactly what it is.
Yeah, exactly. For example, I play Dota a lot, and my most favorite character is Lina. Basically, even though, of course, there are maybe some proportions blown up.
You like the big boobies, do you?
No, that's the thing. That's the thing. I like the character because it's a very good character, not because, you know, it just simply looks good or something like that. Besides, you know... Because you play this character because it looks good, yeah, you're gonna get into some bad characters at that point then. But yeah, that's just that. There was a question from Osama. Ah, your arch nemesis, Sakura, Ninav,
in
Madeline?
Game?
Yeah, in this game, arch nemesis. Do you have one?
Oh, I'm trying to really think.
Does that mean?
I mean, some of that, if that you're constantly running into them and trying to kill them before they kill you, kind of thing.
It's either friendly
sure
or something.
He,
you know, just.
I'm not sure if he plays anymore, but there was a time when every second time I died, it was to Cousin Beckett.
Aha! Uh-huh. I've kind of had a few arch nemesis moments with him as well in ATR. I was chasing his Valkyrie the other day. I'd have to say that on my TR, pretty much every KOTV member, anybody on TeamSpeak, I'm always going after them.
Oh, I do that as well.
I mean, that, and I don't know, I can't really think of any other, I guess for a while there, I kind of was after Darth Sidious as well, because we were buddies and stuff. And Anga as well on TR when I was playing my Vanu. But it wasn't really arch nemesis, it was more like trolling because we were server reps. And anytime one of us would kill each other, we'd send a wink or a smile in game because we were just being dicks. But
yeah.
Someone
yeah.
that constantly go, you! You know, no.
Yeah. I have only got that
Yamix,
one
is yours still Lucas?
If I can, I could try, of course, hunting him. But the thing is, I just hunt anyone I know. That is either from TeamSpeak or that's either some YouTuber. For example, Joshino. Also, one day I actually ran into him while he was playing Vanu. And of course I tried to stick around the area for as long as I could and, you know, hunt for him. I managed maybe kill him twice or something. And then he, of course, managed to kill me the same amount or something.
I do like the fact that he was kind of fun about the fact that you did drive a suicide flash into his prowler.
Oh, yeah, I love that.
That was pretty awesome. He laughed about it, so that kind of like nemesis plays.
Exactly,
good
that's
good.
What
it's
I like.
Fun, and you're not taking it personal. It's just fun.
So, yeah, I suppose there are people that are trying to hunt.
Oh, wait. I did kind of have a little bit of one with Alvarin there for a while when I was on my Vanu.
Ah.
Like, whenever I saw her, I tried to kill her and she tried to kill me.
Hmm. Alright.
That's another female gamer that's not here.
Yeah, definitely. Let's see. What could we else ask? Got extra info. Yeah, just guys, you know, keep on sending in questions. I'll try to ask. Let's see. Fuck. Yeah, fill the time somehow. I don't know.
Somebody asked
my
what
kids?
We I'm are kidding. Doing yeah. when we are not playing what we are doing in our free
yeah.
time.
Yeah.
Oh, that's also good.
Oh
personally,
god, we're gonna sound super girly then, I guess.
go score then, yeah, first.
Me? When I'm not playing PlanetSide 2, I'm reading. I'm a big fucking bookworm. I love sci-fi novels. I go through about 6 books a month. Or I'm watching Netflix. Or I'm doing garden work, or I'm playing with my kids. Fun!
I'm either reading or sewing.
I want to sew more, but I can't. I ain't got time for that.
Yeah, I love reading and doing yoga and stuff.
And, yoga's
yeah,
great.
I make jewelry and stuff like that. Yeah. Like, really girly.
I may have an unholy obsession with dressing my 3-year-old.
Oh boy.
No.
I hope you don't dress him like
it's
a
my,
girl.
It's in like, no, God, no. I like dressing my both my sons very cool. Like, my eldest, I look everywhere for skull t-shirts. I look for cool, you know, I try to find Air Jordans on sale. I try to find cool jeans, stuff that other kids don't have. And
so,
I also, for my 3-year-old, I dress him very colorfully. Like, there's this brand in Sweden called Mini Rodini, and they do all these awesome clothes, and I am always looking online for sales for that. That's another big part of my time, is looking on obscure websites for prints that have gone out of, like, production. But they're awesome! She's got pants with pugs on them! Pugs! They're awesome! I'd wear them if they came in my size.
Oh, pugs
there's,
are
like,
cute.
Black pugs! He's so cute, too! I can't help it! I have to dress him like that. And that's my hobby. I know it's sad, but I do kind of, and my other hobby right now is working on remodeling my son's room, so I'm looking for shit to put in it. I just found his bed, so I have to look for stuff. I did that with my son's rooms as well. My eldest son has a loft bed and graffiti walls, and like a really cool desk that I customized with graffiti and stuff, and he's got his computer on it, and then he's got like really cool stickers everywhere, skater stickers, and I did his cabinets and stuff. So I guess interior design would kind of be a hobby as well.
Yeah, I listen to music a lot and go to concerts and festivals and stuff. That's also here.
I'm too old for that.
You know, at this point, I just heard that you are preparing your children to be cultists.
Yes, cultists.
Yes.
Yes, I'm preparing them for the world to, you know,
for initiation
the
in Illuminati. So,
exactly.
You know.
Nah. I like doing that kind of stuff. I'm a firm believer that they need to be their own people. They need to have their own, like, you don't need to give kids a reason to make fun of them. I mean, for that reason, I do my son's hair before he goes to school because he looks like a total bum otherwise.
Well,
it's like a really nice haircut and he can't be bothered. I'm like, and he got a girlfriend because of it, so that bitch better thank me.
Okay.
They say he smells nice. Who bought him the Playboy spray? Damn, who's got the nice Nikes and is on fleek? Yeah. It's all mom. That's my girlfriend, not his.
Okay.
Motherfuckers are
pedophilia already arising.
Yeah, my 3-year-old, everybody's always smiling when they see him, so I do my part. Like, he's so cute.
Oh, sounds nice.
I mean, like, nice. I sound manly. I'm so manly than most men, then you do this shit as a hobby. Well, I'm sorry to disappoint you, Osama. Sorry to disappoint. Okay, let me retry. I knit. I press wildflowers and I chase butterflies. Is that better?
Oh.
I can't knit to save my life. I have a sewing machine, but the thing sitting in my pan, like in my cellar, I ain't even fucking used it. I sewed bibs. That's it. And then I'm done with this shit. So yeah, if I could sew, I'd sew my kids' clothing, but I just don't have the fucking time for it. And finding the fabric, screw it. Meg, no. And now you know how boring we are.
Yes. Typical females.
I don't know. There was a question about your music taste.
Oy vey.
Alright, Madeline, you start. Your favorite music type, genre, or whatever.
I like metal and rock music and all old stuff, rock and roll, things like that. And yeah, last concert I was on last week where I saw Blind Guardian, which was hell lot of amazing concert.
Oh, I haven't listened to Blind Guardian in forever.
Oh, they are so awesome. They are still awesome. Even though the singer don't has long hair anymore.
Oh god lord, he cut it.
Which is kind of sad. He was in front of the stage and shaking his head and there was no hair.
Look,
but he has such a nice voice. So it's still pretty cool.
I had a thing for Typo Negative, man. That was my music. Peter fucking Steele. And the fact that he was in Playgirl probably didn't make it anymore. He was in Playgirl when I was in high school. Holy shit, that's the most smuggled magazine I've ever fucking seen. He's a, I guess you'd call Typo Negative doom metal. I used to be heavily into grindcore and black metal and that kind of stuff. I was a humongous Cannibal Corpse fan. Morbid Angel, that kind of stuff. But as I got older, I was married to someone before that was heavily into metal, and he just broke it for me for a while. So my first love of music was like classic rock and classical music. So I don't know, my go-tos right now for music are like, I don't know, like classical and stuff like that. I love classical music. I know that's the geekiest thing ever, but it's music that can express so many emotions, like Vivaldi and stuff like that. I love classical. I love a lot of compositions and scores from movies as well, but you know, if I had to pick like one artist I listen to right now, I don't know. I mean, I don't get to listen to music as much as I'd like to because I always have to have like one ear on everything. I don't know. I kind of really like the Bruno Mars song Uptown Funk right now. I know that's so mainstream, but it just kind of reminds me of Motown, and I grew up with that stuff with my mom. So mom used to play a lot of Motown music. It's like Detroit soul music. Yeah, can't go wrong with a little bit of funk. I love funk as well. So yeah, there you go. I'll shut up now. I'll shut the funk up.
Yeah, I'm in the. I mostly listen metal too. I think it's the industrial metal part of it. Then.
Rammstein.
Rammstein, Machine Supremacy.
Yeah.
And things like that.
I used to like KMFDM a lot as well. I liked a lot of obscure groups. I was hardcore, like, oh god, like I was into metal as I got older, but I started out in goth actually. So I liked stuff like Virgin Prunes and Bauhaus and Sex Fiend. Those unknown groups.
I have been having a return to childhood. I've been listening to Modern Talking most of
all. Oh, good God!
It's okay. I still have my David Hasselhoff CD, so.
You know, it's awesome. Yeah. The lead singer of Modern Talking lives like 20 kilometers away from me. I've met him.
Oh dear.
Working at Toys R Us and he came in looking for toys. He was like, hi, I'm like, is that who I think that is? And
I'm so like, Sakura, can I come visit you?
If you want. He lives in Koblenz. That's his hometown. That's where he's always at. You'll always run into him there. It's his apartment and everything's there. Everybody knows where it is. So yeah. There's no Dita. There you go, Yamix.
Alright. Question from myself. If you had to describe Miller community to a person who is never really played Planetside, how would you describe it? Community. Community, basically. How would you describe the community?
As in like how we all interact
in
with
Miller.
Each other.
Yeah, basically.
Trolls who think their KDs are everything? I don't know.
And farmers?
We have a lot of competitive outfits on this server now. And you've got Red October, you've got Innie. You had mercenaries, but they kind of stopped. I mean, yeah.
And then you had the happy-go-lucky people from the Woodman.
Yeah, Woodman was so much more laid back, wasn't it?
It was.
And Miller,
it was
just
pretty nice.
All you have to do is log on to TR when Stumpy Cat is yelling at people on command chat and attempt to give a command or ask a question. And you get your ass handed to you and you go, I miss Woodman. I miss being able to joke around in command chat and just
yes.
not take shit so serious. That I'd probably describe Miller as people who take themselves a bit too serious. Just a little bit.
Yeah, I would.
They're not bad or anything, it's just they're more MLG than we were when we joined. We're like, yo, what's up? We're Miller. We're Miller now. We're Woodmill.
But know? I think they are still like it feels like they are still two different servers. The people are not really
they're the
working kind of good together. It's like, I don't know, kind of different types of playing together. It's I don't know if that's working that good at that point.
Alright, okay, Osama asks, who is the biggest bag of dicks in the community? I suppose.
Biggest bag of dicks is in, like, the most unfriendly person kind of thing?
Supposedly, yeah.
I'm sorry, Stumpy Cat. I have talked to Stumpy Cat and I've had a good conversation with him, but when I first met him, and sometimes in normal chat, he can come across as a very mean person. He is very serious about what he does when he does it, and he does not like people stepping out of line. He can be kind of a dick. And it's not meant personally, Stumpy. You just... Half of TR from Woodman basically has you muted.
TR are dicks.
They do.
That's all I can say.
No. And even Anga, you know, doesn't get along with him. Anga, I mean, seriously, it happens quite often here. Anga and Stumpy Cat arguing in command chat. I mean, it's just... He's just more... He's ex-military. He takes this game very serious. If you even talk in proximity, he will bite your fucking head off. You know, I said, all right, everybody, kneel, because they're making fun of the way that Goon goes in on tech plans. He's like, shut the fuck up, son, go back to your mom. I'm like, Jesus Christ. I'm like, hey, Stumpy, it's me, Sakura. He's like, oh, hey, love, how you doing? I'm like, Jesus Christ, whiplash. I mean, really? I was like, God damn. So, yeah, he's...
All right. Question: worst outfit. Marilyn, I think you would know more, as I've heard Orbs at least talk about this cheater outfit from Vanu the most. I just simply can't remember the name.
Somebody put it up on Reddit today as well.
Yeah,
like
I would say that just
what they were saying.
Fucking cunts. So, but in your opinion, what would be the worst outfit, either from other server or Miller.
I have no idea. I never
worst
compared
outfit?
The outfits.
Blue's pretty shitty. Like, play-wise. I have not come up against someone from Blue yet on the NC side that is any good.
I think they have not that much of experience.
Yeah, it shows.
It's new.
But it's not like I hate them.
No, you don't hate them. They're just not that. I mean, to be honest, worst outfit. I'm gonna have to say it's Dig. Sorry. I'm sorry. I don't like the fact that I had a conversation with Warcore explaining things to him that he didn't even know going on in the outfit about how Floody Man is in Yell Chat. And if I ask anyone, they're always like, yeah, I can't stand Dig. And it's for a reason. It's because they talk a lot of shit in Yellow Chat. They don't do very much tactical, and they just kind of kill fights, and people don't like that. And that's one of my opinion, one of the
but,
worst
outfits. But,
you know,
at the KOTV's time, we supposedly
we were the worst
the
outfit
same.
As well, but the thing is we actually dropped on the right base.
Oh,
no,
that's a
not
burn.
Many, it's shady, and it's burn, bitch, but we may have been zerging, but motherfuckers, we dropped where we were supposed to. And that's the thing. I mean, there's a lot of team killing from their side as well. So, yeah. It's just, they've kind of ruined playing Vanu for me anyway. It's just, I find it really difficult to find, and I think a lot of people, I say it in Yell Chat, the moment a bunch of Vanu drop, the first thing you see from Yell Chat, from NC or TR is, thanks, Dig, for ruining the fight. You know? So, they can hate me all I want for having my opinion, but that's just how I feel about them. It's not a vendetta, it's just an opinion. Do you have any spare ammo? There's a vendetta, then I tried to, you know, I leave KOTV, I'd infiltrate Dig, I'd get command, and I'd kick them all! No.
Now they are going to hunt you down and find you everywhere.
Oh no, I'm so scared. Do you have any spare
can't talk because he can recognize you.
Yeah. Well, I don't talk very much on my TR, so it's nice to just be able to play and not have somebody go, "Hey, you want to lead a platoon?" No, it's okay. You know.
Hmm. All right. As we are playing plan side, basically, what is the best thing that happened to you the time you actually play this game? For me, it's actually, you know, getting on TeamSpeak and talking to people. You know, having more friends! After all, I'm lonely!
Yeah, accidentally joining Moo.
Accidentally?
Yes, I have no idea how I have joined, but at some point I noticed I'm in an outfit. That would be Moo.
That happens to me when I join Gods without even noticing that I'm joining an outfit.
I'd have to say the best thing for me is when I started doing server rep. As much as it's a pain in the ass and you have to deal with a lot of stuff like doing last minute rosters and statistic sheets, it's a lot of fun because you get to meet a lot of different people from different servers, and I loved being Woodman's rep because the meetings were always awesome. Everybody was always so friendly. You could make friendly pokes and jabs at each other without people's dicks getting stepped on. Unfortunately, I'm like Miller now. You gotta be careful what you say sometimes because some people take it personally. But that, I just loved being a part of the Woodman, you know, server smash stuff. It was great. I still enjoy it a lot now, but I miss the Woodman days.
Yeah, good old Woodman. I miss it.
Yeah.
Screw Miller.
Those are the days.
Yeah.
Yeah, well, we lost that fucking smash.
Yeah. But, I mean, we were more of a casual server than the tryhard server. It was to be seen that we would lose. A lot of us had resigned ourselves to that fate when it happened.
True.
Satriani, don't you try to act like we didn't have any meetings. You just didn't show up to them. Saying in fucking YouTube stream chat. He always showed up late.
Oh well.
Yeah, well, in our hearts we can keep Woodman alive forever.
We've all got wood inside us.
Yep. The morning wood and all kinds of other wood.
Yeah, where you been, Damix? Jesus.
What?
Did you fall down a hill in the woods or something? You got that much wood in you?
No. I got hit in the head by a block of wood.
Stake in the heart.
Yeah, also. Cause I'm a vampire. Bleh!
Bleh, bleh, bleh. Jesus Christ. And Yamix, any other more brilliant questions?
Well, I don't know. For now, it doesn't look like it. Besides, we've been already live for an hour and 40 minutes, so... Oh, I don't know. Do we have any other questions?
I have one question.
Ah, go.
Would you guys like to have another faction on the game? A fourth faction?
Fourth faction. Well, technically we already have, you know, the fourth faction as the faction switching piece of shit. Yeah, but...
Yeah, makes down.
I mean something weird, like...
Yeah, I get...
Empires or aliens,
yeah. The thing is with the planet
talking
side...
talking about the Black Company, or that Black... that... the faction... the proportion of players that would jump the factions during the alert...
Yeah, that has sounded... factioners.
No, the in-game mechanic for it, there has been something said about that. That sounds fun.
Mm. I think another faction would be interesting, because then there'd be new stuff to check out.
Well, yeah. The thing is, what's the point of adding more factions to the game if we basically have nothing to do already in the game, really? You know, go to the base, capture, and move on. It doesn't really come... rewarding to capture bases nowadays. You don't get the extra resources for capturing bases in any continent. Maybe one nanite per minute and so on. But that doesn't really give anything. I remember the olden days when you had all the resource system. You basically had to capture certain bases to get enough resources for certain things. Still remember in was it Amarish where
it was Pepperidge Farm.
Yeah. exactly.
Back in my day.
I like the old resource system, and besides, this one is still not fucking complete, and oh, look at that, we have actually Hulky online. Hey.
What?
In TeamSpeak. But yeah, that's that.
But I said that like an hour ago.
Oh, never mind.
Yummy.
Sorry, I have 10 other places where to look.
I know, so. You've got 10 other dicks in yours.
Of course, every orifice is filled with dicks. And more dicks than them. So, dicks all of them.
Bags of dicks?
Probably. Sheesh. But yeah, game needs more.
Needs more garlic.
Just needs more menial content, I'd say. Content that actually matters, not, you know, pointless cosmetics or weapons. That's what I basically mean with that.
Yeah.
Alright, I'll take a look at the questions. But yeah, alright. I think. That's it on the questions, and.
Someone just wrote something about community relations with Daybreak Games. Thoughts on Reddit side, forum side, etc. You were trying to avoid that one, weren't you?
No. One side community and Daybreak. It's rather a loaded question. I mean, Daybreak as a company doesn't really change that much after, Daybreak became Daybreak. The problem is,
well, they've pretty much killed the community.
Yeah,
there's
they killed the community
with them whatsoever anymore, and it is ridiculous.
They fired pretty much everyone who was working contacting with the community, talking with them. Of course, some of them were, you know, still left and still do their work, but the majority of the connections are cut. So he can't really talk or influence anything.
Well, I noticed from the server rep side that we used to get server smash accounts so much earlier, and now it's seriously like so slow.
Yeah, exactly.
Day of the event accounts. And that's bad because you've got to hand, 400 accounts out in a short amount of time and make rosters and get stuff asserted. So it's definitely completely broken down.
Alright, there's Brady wants me to say, I love you guys, I suppose.
And someone asked if you have children, will you encourage them to play PS2?
If I would ever
so
have them,
you,
I
Sakura.
Probably would force them to play Duke Nukem all day long until they are...
I do have children, I have two of them, one of them is 3 and one of them is 11. The 3-year-old, no, because he's still playing with board boxes and teddy bears. The 11-year-old, I actually did down in front of the computer and let him try, because I knew he'd fail. Because he watches me play, and he's like, I want to try, Mom! I'm like, alright. I kind of might have put him on my TR and actioned him, and he just got shot in the face and gave up.
Oh.
The reason why is my son's really good with Minecraft, but anything too hectic and too much overloads him because he has ADD, and I know for a fact that he would not be able to deal with it yet. He's not at that point to where he could play this game without completely losing his shit. And that's honestly like, that's why I did. I said it's a lot more difficult. I wanted to prove to him that it's more difficult than it looks. It's kind of mean to do it that way, but I didn't want him to act like he could play and then get really frustrated and just be pissed. I said, okay, I'm going to do what I did. That's exactly how the game starts, though, if you think about it. You answer a questionnaire and it instant actions you. I gave him the exact same experience I had when I started the game, except for he had better asserted character.
Oh, yeah.
So, yeah. I mean, it depends on what kind of kids you have if they can play this game. If they're into these kind of things, yeah, but I don't let my kids really, believe it or not, I may play first-person shooter games, but my son has no first-person shooter games. He has, like, the typical Nintendo games, like Smash Brothers and Lego games and a couple of other games, but, Mario Kart and shit like that, but I don't let my kids play those kind of games. He's not prepared for it. He has laser tag weapons and stuff like that, but he wants to play GTA, and I said no.
Oh, yeah.
No.
Yeah!
No.
Come on!
No!
It was like I played And Duke Nukem, and like a couple of years later, I
That's
was
different.
then, and
you
I played
up hookers,
GTA
for
3.
I know, GTA's, he's not quite there yet. He's not mature enough. You know, you pick as a parent. I let him watch superhero movies and stuff like that, but no. I would encourage, I would love to play this game with my son. I really would. I'd find it awesome. But he's just not at that point yet. And by the time the 3-year-old can play this game, will be long dead.
Alright, there was a question. What do you think about PlanetSide coming to PS4? Alright, Merlin, you start.
I think it's taking
start.
Away from resources.
Just, Merlin, you start.
I don't play console games. I mean, I still have my Super Nintendo, which still works, but I don't have the PlayStation or something else, so... I don't know. I don't care. I'm not sure what to say.
No, oh, alright. You have barely any, you know, comment because you don't have it. Alright. Nina?
I play Nipponichi games on PlayStations.
So
they have a few series. They are the click and wait.
Alright.
And
so
you
have
you
also no opinion on PlanetSide 2 coming to PS4?
Nope.
Alright, Sakura?
I think it's a big fucking mistake. I can't imagine playing this game on a console. The problem I have is that they've directed so many of their resources to the console release that they've completely broken the PC version. Trying to get shit to work on the console has led to problems in the PC version, and in my opinion, I don't think they're really going to make... I don't think they're going to do as great as I think they're going to, because people like... I don't like Halo and stuff like that. I don't like first-person shooters on consoles. I'm not a fan of it. I'm more of a beat-em-up gamer on consoles, and like stuff like... I do like Lollipop Chainsaw Massacre. That was a really fun game, because it was a chick cheerleader with a chainsaw. Come on, killing zombies.
That
sounds good.
It was sexist,
misogynist, and cheesy as shit, but it was awesome.
Misogyny. That game should be banned everywhere by, you know, feminists.
Dude, watch Soul Calibur and Mortal Kombat, how much their tits bounce when they fight.
Oh, yeah.
Ivy
oh, yeah.
on Soul Calibur, for Christ's sakes, has pretty much got a wedgie the whole time she's fighting.
Yeah, that's like, what the fuck?
It's just, those are the games I like to play on consoles. I have Halo, and I've played it with my friends when they were, like, my husband's friends when they were here. Yeah. I just think it's great that they're trying it on the PS4, but I don't think they're going to have as much success as they think. I think it's going to bomb. This is a really good PC game. It functions well in PC. Trying to translate this over to PS4, I really, really don't know.
I just want to say that looking at Ivy hurts.
Yes. Guys, like, fighting in heels and a tanga. Ay.
Yeah. Right.
Them kicks.
All right. My opinion on this thing is already laid down before people who really want to watch the videos I made about it. So, you know, just go and watch them. I'm not gonna repeat myself again. But you know, long story short, I think it's terrible. But if they really want to cash in, sure, go and kill yourselves. That's on that. Let's see, we have any questions? Doesn't really look like it.
What is your sign?
bullshit. That's bullshit. Fucking astrology.
Well, you're a fish, aren't you? No, I'm just kidding.
That's bullshit. No. Anyways, I think it's been 2 hours already, so I think it's a good sort of a Q&A type of thing, and... maybe
if you ever ask now or forever, hold your question.
Yeah, exactly. The last question, last two questions. So, guys, come on.
We'll just go to the 2-hour mark and then stop. You've got 8 minutes left. I put some Jeopardy music on.
Okay. So the last question. Come on. While your people are writing their questions, I'll just say that if you like this thing, you can, you know, support me in the Patreon.
If you like,
give me monies. Give me monies.
Don't give him money. Don't give this man money. He uses it to buy weed.
You encourage me to make more shit, so you know.
Oh look, someone loves you. That's
oh,
nice.
Good.
Imagine that. Yeah, that's
How
a surprise.
Old are you? It must be like 10 years old and find you awesome.
Yeah, imagine I can die happy now. At least somebody
I can take care of that
me.
For you right now. Come here.
No. Never. I'll die before I...
Oh yes, what our favorite game is in Faction, we've kind of already did that one.
Yeah.
Oh! That's... There you go, how did you pick your player name?
Well... not the question for me, really, so... Madeline?
I have that kind of nickname since I'm 16, something like that. And yeah, I chose it because I'm a big Marilyn Monroe fan. And yeah, the other numbers are my wife's birth year, so... Not that fancy.
Oh no, that's cool. That's cool, actually. Let's see. Alright, Nina. That's an actually interesting name. I can't really pin it to anything else, so... Where did you get it?
When I started playing Baldur's Gate some 10 years ago, 15 years ago, something like that, I had to pick something, and I picked Nineveh, but then being in the internet with the name Nineveh, that's an Italian first name for women, I had to change it because I couldn't take Italian men, so it became Nineveh.
Molto bella!
Okay.
Ciao!
Alright, and Sakura?
Alright. So, I kind of had an obsession with horror movies for a really long time, and I used to be active in a lot of forums, and I had, you know, names like Killer Bitch and stuff. You can't use Killer Bitch. Killer Bitch was my tag in Unreal Tournament. And Sakura is Japanese for cherry blossoms. So I kind of wanted to go with a contrast thing. If you remember Marilyn Manson, if you ever looked at some of the people's names in the group, they were a stark contrast, like Marilyn and Manson. It's kind of like that, like Sakuras are beautiful and gore's gory, so... Yeah, that's pretty much it.
Alright.
That's cool.
And the question, where do you live? I'm
from
Latvia!
I'm not telling you that, you suckers!
I'm from Latvia! Ciao! Sakura?
I'm from Finland.
Okay, so Finland, Sakura is from Germany, and Madeline also Germany.
Yeah.
But
Bavaria.
Sakura!
I'm from Germany, but I'm not German.
Exactly.
As you can tell by my chewing gum voice, I'm from America! Freedom, y'all! I'm originally from Michigan, Flint, Michigan.
Nuke, Michigan, that's pressed. All I'm gonna say.
Shut your face! Flint, Michigan, motherfuckers. Grew up there, came over here 15 years ago to be on a television show called Andreas Turk to meet my ex-husband. Yeah, I was on the Andreas Turk show. And decided to stay here and went back. Yeah, wanted to go to move to England, but they kind of banned me from the country, so I'm stuck here.
Banned you what?
Yeah, I'm playing for mentoring for 10 years.
How the hell?
Four more. Yeah, when you... this is a word of advisory, children. If you ever go to England, do not fly on a one-way ticket because you think it's cheaper. I've got ammo for you. The lovely British borders, borders, UK stuff there, will flag you and basically go, well, remember, what are you doing? And if you say, well, I wanted someone to visit my boyfriend and I wanted to see how jobs were here, yeah. They'll send you right back home on the next plane. And if you try to come again with your boyfriend with a round-trip ticket to visit his parents, they will ban you for 10 years. Stupid, isn't it? You'd think that
seriously?
They'd ban
them. Well, sounds like British needs some ass-whooping on this thing.
UK borders is very strict, so be very careful when you travel there. Even if you're European, they will look at you very carefully. So my biometrics are in the system for 10 years, that's why.
The fuck?
And how long has it been, actually?
The guy was so friendly, scanning my passport. He's like, hello, did you have a lovely flight? I'm like, yeah, great. And he scans my passport. He's like, 1 minute. I'm like, son of a bitch.
So actually, interesting. How much has it, you know, still left for you to wait until you can return to the Great Britain?
4 years?
Okay, then.
Do
you want to go
there?
I get
my passport this year. Basically what happened is because I went home to help my mom out in America, I missed the mark to come back and I lost all of my, like, Aufenthaltsgenehmigung here. So I had to start from scratch again. I was right before being able to get my citizenship, and because I was out of the country 2 weeks too long, I lost it all! And so I had to restart, so next year I'm going to be able to get my German citizenship. Yeah.
Oh, okay. So,
and then once I have the German citizenship, I can walk and just throw my passport in their face and be like, fuck you, I'm coming in! See that, bitch? Thug life, yo. You know, put some sunglasses on. But yeah. Everybody always thinks that that's an interesting story. It's not interesting being locked up with a bunch of men from Africa and India in one holding cell. That's not meant to be racist. It's an actual thing. It smelled like curry.
All right.
It did.
All right. Not judging. No.
Africa in itself has a different hygiene than other continents. It's known. It's not a racist thing. It's just a culture thing.
Sure. Not judging.
I'm not racist like
not
you.
Judging. Okay, not judging.
Yeah.
No. Not a judgmental person. Not at all.
So yeah. I'm just an American living in Germany married to an Englishman.
That's so weird.
Yeah. With the kid. One kid who's English and one's German. There's so many fucking passports in this house.
Alright. The last thing. Do any of you can do any voice impressions or, you know, things like that?
Moo?
I know Sakura could do a couple of them.
What? Like what?
Impressions of either characters on the TV or things like that.
I can do like Barney a little bit.
Yeah, do it.
Oh god, I'm being put under pressure. It's gonna suck now.
Do it, please.
Hey, Oma.
That's about it. But I could do accents and stuff like that. American ones are easy because hi, I'm America. Boston, New York. Down south, y'all. I like doing those telepreachers.
Oh, yeah, that's perfect.
The Baptist ones. No, Jesus! Jesus Christ is there with you, yes, sir! You know, that kind of thing.
Yeah, those are always funny.
Your face. You, the demons are within ya. We need to heal ya.
Actually, that could be the next Idiotor Axis bit someplace, probably. I don't know.
The Lord Jesus is with ya. Praise Jesus! Can I get an amen?
Amen! Alright. Been 2 hours and 5 minutes already, so... Well, I suppose that's about it, right?
My ass is asleep too, so it's...
Yeah, okay, that's a good sign.
What,
good as
my
any.
Asleep?
Good as any.
My fucking headphones hurt after a while.
Sure. Anyways, thanks for coming. I hope it was interesting for you to participate in and people for watching.
Yeah, thanks for having us.
So, yet again, you know, maybe we could do something again in between outfits or something. I don't know. We'll see.
Afro-American, what?
Say what?
Somebody just called me Afro-American.
Okay.
You mean African-American.
Afro.
Yeah, excuse me. Yeah, I wear a wig to cover my afro.
All right.
Afro-American.
Oh, all right. Oh. Anyways, thanks, fellas, for watching. And as always, you know, Patreon, bitch, give me my money.
Don't give him nothing.
All right.
Bitch, but I have my money. Okay,
but yeah, that actually supports, and you know, the more people, you know, support me, the easier it will become to
and
make.
Remember,
more.
You support Yamix's online porn subscriptions with that.
You know, the porn is for free, so that goes to the lube.
Yeah, he likes. He likes following those websites where women get fed. So he has to pay to be a part of those websites. he's a feeder. And that's
on that cheery note. On that cheery note, we end.
No.
Okay. That's about it.